I'm Simulator Dirk, and welcome back to Transim World. Back on the road after having my SPAD. We're going to do the scenario again and hopefully this time complete it. I did actually watch the video that Rivet Games put out in relation to how to drive the train. Now, there were some things that were handy that I learnt and that I'll show you. There's supposed to be another video coming about how to operate the train management system, although that doesn't appear to have been uploaded yet. Okay, so here we are. We're at the cab door. Now, I learnt that the main lock that they want us to use is the one actually on the door. So we'll get in. Now we have to unlock this door. We do have to unlock the conductor's door. And then we can open this one. Now I found here that you have various things for your safety systems which we hadn't done before. So you need to do Okay, so you need that one. This is for your various safety systems. That one. Driver reminder. AWS. Vigilance is on. Selective door opening is on. Emergency brake is on. Traction interlock is on. The PASCOM is on. So they are all on. So everything's been opened up. We can now close it. Oh, we need to do the TWS isolation, so we unisolate it. And then we need to close the door. Okay, so in we go. Sit in the seat. Open the cab door. I want me to open the cab door. Maybe it did want me to open the one. This one. Okay, so it wanted me to open that one, even though in the Rivet video, which are the developers, you have to press the one indicated. Okay, so I've learned something. All right, sit in the driver's seat. Master key to on, DDS to forward, acknowledge the system, marker lights, open the map, so we need to set. These points, these points. Now the TMS, apparently there's a video coming on how to operate the TMS. Yeah, we can confirm that it's four cars. Okay, so now we can take off. Because we're in a yard. So with the TMS, you're supposed to be able to set up announcements, but we won't be doing that on this empty run. So what we have done by setting up the driver safety systems is that in the previous episode, above the speedo there was a temporary isolation fault light on. Now that's gone off because we've actually activated the driver safety systems. Now in Rivet's own video they say that you do not need to use the driver safety systems to actually operate the train. But as we'll see, it's a lot more realistic if you do. So the sunflower next to the control panel where it says overspeed, temporary traction system fault, etc. That is on because we're in a yard. So there's no cleared signal, so that will remain lit, and they call it a sunflower because it basically looks like a sunflower. I did try another scenario. Alright, throttle to max. The DDS to off. And take the key, and we will change our marker lights to tail lights at this point, which is something we didn't do straight away. Now I'm going to leave the cab open because I did learn that we are going to be using this cab again. But of course we need to secure it away from passengers. Now when we're attached to another unit, we'd have to have that locked so passengers can go from one half to the other. So we'll start opening our doors. Now we have to open the conductor's door first. so we can then open that door. Now on this side I'm going to just turn on all of the things that we did at the other end. So they'll also work at this end. Now I don't know for sure, but in systems that I've operated on, all of this would be on by default and you wouldn't turn it off unless it needed to be turned off due to an issue. So we'll do that. And we should be right now to sit in the seat. And we'll turn our master key on. Enter forward. We'll change our marker lights on. We need to reset the junctions. Turn our TMS on. Now in-game TMS is optional as well. And we are ready to go. Isolation fault for the driver safety system has been reset. Control system knows when the driver is doing something, so they don't need the flashlights or sound bells or anything, because they know what they're doing through the use of task link functions. So it knows that I powered and shut off then, and so it knows that yes, I'm still here. That's the whole idea of the vigilance control system, to say, okay, I am still here, I'm alive, doing what I should be doing. And then you've got extra things like your AWS, your ETCS, which is your automatic train protection, that sort of thing. But the vigilance system, it's a great system when it works well. And if you're doing things task link, well, it will know that you are, that you're alive and well and doing stuff. Okay, set the junction again. And hopefully that's it. No, there must be another one down further. because we did it before, we have some idea how this scenario works now. Still in the yard, so it's still very low speed at this stage. Now the fact that the shunting signal's clear won't necessarily reflect on the AWS, the advanced warning system, if you're in a yard. But once you get onto a main line, we'll see the difference now that it's activated. Still very low speed at this point. Now what would be interesting to see, and I don't really know the answer to this, the spad that I had in the previous episode that almost didn't happen because we passed the signal by a couple of meters. If I had the AWS on, would that have prevented the spad? And I seriously, at this point, don't know the answer to that. See, our next signal's cleared for us as well. No rush to get out of the yard. They know that you're not, the timetable knows that you're not running 100 miles an hour through the yard. So enough time's given. So very slow process to get out of any yard. The overshoot that I decided to delete because I also got interrupted by real life at the same time, and that took priority. It was an interesting one because I pressed the buttons to start braking and nothing happened. Episode and potential overshoot in the next would not have been great for my ScotRail career. Okay, so our speed limit's gone up a little bit now. And as I've said before, I don't particularly know this route. Our sunflower is still on. And we have a signal coming up about 350 yards anyhow. stop at this way marker. Because we have to get out of the train again. Now, in real life, there would probably be car markers to let you know where you need to stop appropriately for your train. Alright, so we need to cut out again. Master key out. We'll change our marker lights to tail. We'll leave the cab set up. I'm just going to have to change it to get anyway. And also the conductor as well. Now I don't know which light rail services have conductors and which don't. All the doors are fortunately still open from previously. That's interesting, I thought I locked that cab from... Oh, hang on, this isn't the cab. So everything's still set up from before. Sit in the seat. Master key on. Alright, here we are, green signal. We're already in the TMS. Bit of horn, we're on a main line so we don't need inching movement. Now, by right, as soon as we pass this signal, the subway should go out. Thank you. I didn't think that I activated my emergency brake, but obviously I did. Yellow. So we'll run over the detector for a moment. So we know we're going to go into the loop. And we can just start a while with a red signal. Now in some areas they will need you to pull up right at the signal. In other areas, and I know I see the real world freight train drivers do this especially, is that they'll hang back a fair way from the actual signal once they've actually come to a stop. And because their trains are so long. Man, I was doing so well. Well, let's complete this next scenario. Oh no, I'm not going to have a job shortly. So much for AWS. Alright, so this is a different scenario. Let's hope we can do better at this one. Our career is really welcome to Springburn West. Wait for the signal to change, then continue operating the train to Glasgow Queen Street. On arrival, unload all passengers and start a new passenger service to Waverley. Alright, so what I need to do, because it hasn't set up anything for me because we're on a new train, new scenario, is set up these things again. Now it's interesting, I can't actually see the labels this time. Done everything. We have to do this isolation switch. Get in the seat. My graphics have gone really bad. Hopefully that's better. Yep. Right, marker lights on. We'll turn our TMS on. Our master key in. Our DDS to forward. Acknowledge the AWS. We'll finish setting up our management system. So we've only got 3 cars on this occasion. All right, we have the signal, I believe. They put you in a really bad spot when you first get going. Tunnel, and then we'll come up Wayne Street. I hit the buffers then. I shouldn't laugh, but quite frankly, I shouldn't have a job. All right, what's it saying now? Loading and unloading passengers. Gotta wait for it to do its thing. So you think you're coming in nice, and then in that last little bit, okay, follow leg at max, DDS 2 off, take the key, get out of the seat. Yeah, I think we did hit the buffers, then we'll come back. That's what it certainly looked like in cab. Which is interesting because it didn't say, oh, are we still doing this? Oh, you have found a sign thing. Oh no, it's a recycling centre. I was wondering, why is that green? Because their station signs are void. As usual, is not set up for us. Driver's seat. Change our headlights now. In. Load up our TMS. Here we go, auto announce.
For your safety and comfort, smoking is prohibited at all stations and on all train services. This includes e-cigarettes. Please take extra care when getting on and off trains.
Thank you.
This is Bishop Briggs. Please take extra care when getting on and off trains.
Thank you.
the selective door opening didn't work. Just that last little bit again. Once I get into the routine, I'll be okay.
Station announcement.
This is Croy. This train is for Edinburgh Waverley.
Oh, it even says Edinburgh in the window. That's cool. Yep, it's that last little bit that's getting me.
Falkirk High.
This is the first time I'm actually seeing these stations.
This is Falkirk High. This train is for Edinburgh Waverley. Welcome to the ScotRail service to Edinburgh Waverley. The next station is Holmont.
So 3.1 miles this time, not enough time to really get up to speed in the way that we did last.
We'll soon arrive at Holmont. This is Holmont. Welcome to the ScotRail service to Edinburgh Waverley. The next station is Linlithgow.
Too bad. Thank you. I went the wrong way. I hit the emergency brake instead of...
This is Linlithgow. Welcome to the ScotRail service to Edinburgh Waverley. The next station is Haymarket.
Okay, the train ahead of you has broken down and blocked the main line. You have gained access to the passenger loop.
Station is he market. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train.
Thank you.
This is Haymarket. This train is for Edinburgh Waverley. The next station is Edinburgh Waverley.
Stop at Edinburgh Waverley platform on overnight.
We'll soon arrive at Edinburgh Waverley. We'll soon arrive at Edinburgh Waverley. Please take extra care when getting on and off trains. Don't forget to take your belongings with you before you leave the train. We'll soon arrive at Edinburgh Waverley. is Haymarket. This is Haymarket.
No, it's not. Oh, that's glitchy AF. So we have arrived in Edinburgh, so we can do the whole route from Glasgow to Edinburgh, which is awesome. Now we will lock the doors, and that should complete the scenario. Okay, this run is now complete. So let me see, I hit the buffers at Queen Street. A couple of overshoots. Still got a gold medal. And I wasn't even really that late. Oh, in the end, I was pretty good. I was due in at 15.07 and I arrived at 15.08. So that was pretty good. I'm now level 33, Edinburgh, Glasgow, which is the route level 6 and level 6 for this train. Anywho, I've been Simulator Duck. You've been wonderful. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time and bye for now.